Good morning. Once again, after a few days, with the same topic of population composition, we are here. In this situation, please don't come out from your house. You stay at your home, subscribe my channel, get day-to-day update of your syllabus, and stay tuned with me. So first of all, we'll recap what we have understood. We have understood the S6 pyramid. We have understood H6 pyramid. We have understood about the H6 pyramid. How many types of H6 pyramid was there? We have discussed there are three types of H6 pyramid. Such H6 pyramid says about what? H6 pyramid says about the population information. It gives us the population information regarding the male and female number. Not only that, on the basis of the male and female number, we can understand also the characteristics of the society, advancement of them. So, three types of H6 pyramid, what they were? Expanding, means whose base is totally white, bell-shaped, that is the comparatively less white. And next one, very narrow base. The very narrow base says about the advanced society, where birth rate is very low, where death rate is comparatively less. The people, they can live long, they can enjoy the long life. Second one, from the last, the second one, the expand, that is comparatively less narrower, that is bell-shaped. That bell-shaped is to say about that the country which is going to be achieved to the advanced country level. And next one, the widening, that is very wide base. Wide base says about what? Says about that the country which is very much underdeveloped condition, where the population, there is no control on the population, population growth rate. There is huge number of births, but due to the lack of medical facilities, due to the lack of advancement, scientific disadvancement, the people, they cannot enjoy the good life. So it was the base, it was the matter of discussion. In this present context, what is going on all over the world? Now we are going to see and redefine the country's level. Are they really advanced or less advanced? If we take the example of Italy, China, such type of country, they are advanced. We know that they are advanced. But in the present context, we are seeing that the death rate in such countries, in this pandemic condition, is very high. So in your mind, there might have the question, are they really advanced country? It may reflect on the S6 pyramid. Yes, if we construct the S6 pyramid after this pandemic condition, yes, their S6 pyramid may be different. But prior to that, what was the condition of them? That was different. So the countries, those which are advanced, so-called advanced, they may not have such awareness that in this pandemic condition, why they should stay inside the room, why they stay inside the residential place, why they will not come out from their residential houses, such type of lack of awareness. The people died in huge number. And this kind of pandemic condition also shows that the pathetic condition of the healthcare service, which not able to support that the huge number of people who are affected in such diseases. So in this condition, what is the role of India? Just once you recap, just we will see.
that almost all of the Indian, we are inside the room, we are inside our residential place, we are not coming out from our house. So I hope that in this condition, the age sex pyramid in comparison to the other developed countries may be different after a few days. So there might have the change in the shape of the age sex pyramid for India. So later on we will discuss about it when you will come to my place once again. We will meet to you. That time in details we will discuss about it. Now in this video, I want to give you the remaining part of the chapter, that is the population composition on the basis of the residential place. So on the basis of the age, on the basis of the sex or the gender, we have discussed about the population composition. Now on the basis of the residential place or place of living, we can divide also the population of the world into two categories. One is referred as the rural and another is referred as urban. Rural and urban, you are familiar with the word. What is the meaning of rural? Rural means the village. Next one, urban means what? Urban means the city. What is the basic characteristics of them? Rural area, in the context of India, maximum people, till now the 60%, more than 60% of population, they live in rural areas. What is the characteristics of the rural areas? The population, those who are living in a particular village, their number is comparatively smaller than any city. We have to remember, the first difference between a village and city or the urban area and the rural area, that is on the basis of number of population. The number of population in a particular unit, that is village, it is comparatively less than any city. So rural area indicates about less population. Next one, city is saying about the large population. In your textbook, you will see that there is a rural-urban composition. Rural-urban composition, obviously the first basic difference we have got. Here we will get the economic activities in which they are engaged. What economic activity they used to do in the rural area? The rural area says about agriculture. And allied works. Agriculture and related agricultural works. Related to the agricultural works. What agriculture includes? Agriculture includes the production of various crops, production of different types of vegetables, etc. Not only that, rearing of cattle, rearing of the different kinds of animals for milk, for skin, for collecting of the fur, for collection of eggs. Everything comes under this activity, and this kind of activity can be also referred as the primary activity. Primary activities. In your lower class you have learned about that primary activities also include mining, but in the rural areas mining is not the characteristics. If we find any kind of mining place, that turned into a city. Later on we will discuss in the different chapter, we will discuss about it. So basically the rural areas, the people they are in the rural areas, the people they are engaged in agriculture, primary activities. But on the other hand, the city or the urban areas, the people are engaged secondary and tertiary activities. Tertiary activities means
non-agriculture, secondary and the tertiary activities, both are related to the non-agriculture. Non-agricultural activities. So non-agricultural activities means what? Industries are there. Non-agricultural activities also include business. Non-agricultural activities also includes the services, etc. So population in the city, they are mainly associated to the non-agricultural activities which do not which never include the agriculture directly. But for the survival, we have to remember, for the survival of the people, those who are living in the urban areas, we need the support of the rural areas. As the city is characterized by the large number of population, due to the situation, due to the accumulation of large number of population in the city, we are not able to provide the scope of agriculture. That is why the rural areas, those which are located in the surroundings of a city, they are the provider of the material which are required for our subsistence. Such as vegetables, food crops, everything are coming from the rural areas. Basically, in the rural-urban composition, we will see that the condition continent-wise, which continent where the people are engaged, where the people are living in huge number in rural areas. And the people where the people are living in urban areas, in which continent? In maximum number. Maximum European countries, North American countries, the people, they are living in urban areas. Means the urban composition of population is more than the rural areas. In India, like South Asian countries, Southeastern Asian countries, the people, they are living mainly in rural areas. So automatically we can understand what will be their occupation. So in the advanced countries, in the European countries or North American countries, we usually see that the more number of urban population who are engaged in the sedentary activities, whereas the people in Asia, they are Asia, Africa, they are related to the agriculture. They are living in where? They are living in the rural areas. Their occupation is mainly what? Mainly agriculture and primary activities. Now, with the reference of your textbook, I want to mark some lines. In according to my textbook, it is the page number 19. A population composition under the rural urban composition, you will see that the figure the rural and urban differences in sex ratio in Canada and West European countries like Finland are just the opposite to those in the African and Asian countries like Zimbabwe and Nepal respectively. So underline this particular line in your textbook and try to give the emphasis on it, the discussion. Rural urban composition says about the primary activities, we have learned about it. So after this, after the occupation, now we are coming to the sex ratio. Sex ratio of the place. There is also difference in the sex ratio. So what we want to say? We want to say that the different kind of aspects on the basis of the living of the place of the people, that is rural and urban. Sex ratio is different. In which respect different? The countries, those which are very much urbanic, we can say that where the urban people are more, we can say, see that the sex ratio is different with the other Asian countries. What we used to see in the Asian countries or African countries, there is huge imbalance in the sex ratio. The sex ratio, already I have discussed in the Essex pyramid. In case of Essex pyramid, the countries, those which are less advanced, we can see that less number of female population. What is this? Might have the discrimination. So we are saying also, by keeping it in our mind, that there is also that the such type of phenomenon found in the rural and urban areas. In Asian countries, in the context of India, we can see sex ratio in some villages.
or in the rural areas. It might so it usually show that the very high number of female. Is it actually so? The number of female in the more number of female in the total population of a village do not indicate the good condition of women. It do not says about the good condition of women in respect of their availability of facilities, etc. Then what? What is the reason behind having that the highest huge number of female workers, female population in the rural areas of India or Asian countries? We have to remember the female, they used to remain in village. Female, they usually remain in village. Then what? The male, they used to migrate. Male, they used to migrate. Migrate where? They used to migrate in the urban areas in search of betterment, in search of livelihood. So that when the female, they are not moving towards the any other urban place due to such situation, the number of female, they used to increase in the total number of population. This doesn't mean that the female, they are in the good condition in such countries. So in the third world countries, we can see there is the imbalance in the sex ratio due to migration also. Migration sometimes says about the good condition in the rural areas, but we have to remember it that female, they do not migrate from the village to the urban areas in generally. That is why female population, they usually increase in the rural areas. So I think it is clear to you. Next one, another line you have to emphasize, give the emphasis, look at, please see your textbook. In the same rural-urban composition, under the heading of the rural-urban composition, in Western countries, male outnumber females in rural areas and females outnumber the males in urban areas. In Western countries, males outnumber females in rural areas. So the situation, what is the meaning of this outnumber? Outnumber means who are more in number. So in the rural areas, we can see that the more number of male, where? In rural areas, in the countries like USA, in the countries like Canada, etc. So that the situation is different. Very easily we can understand the situation is different in advanced countries as well as also less advanced countries. So whatever. Next one, please look at your textbook. Canada and Europe is the result of the influx of the female from the rural areas to avail the fast job opportunities. Have you got, I think you have got the, you will get the particular line. What is Canada and Europe is the result of the influx of the females from rural areas to avail the fast job opportunities. Where they are going? They are going to the urban areas. Means their condition, their social condition is saying that they are ready to migrate from the rural areas to the urban areas. Next one, by contrast, the sex ratio in Asian urban areas remains male dominated due to the predominance of male migration. It is also owed nothing that the countries like India, female participation in farming activity in rural areas is fairly high. Already I have discussed regarding this. So on the basis of that particular line, you will understand, you will see my video and you will understand this one. What is that the female participation in Asian countries in the rural areas in primary activities is high. So what we are saying, in the rural areas in Asia, Asian countries like population engagement, who
are engaged in what type of activities, male or female, that we will discuss. In the rural areas of Asia, female are maximum in female population maximum engaged in agricultural activities. Agricultural activities, female are mainly engaged. Whereas in urban areas of such countries, such Asian countries, the urban population, they are dependent on the non-agricultural practices. But the situation, but the picture is different for the European countries and North American countries, very particularly USA. Whereas maximum male, those who are living in the rural areas, they are related to the agriculture. So it is the difference. So what differences we are getting in the rural urban composition? Once again, the rural areas means the village, whereas urban areas means the city. Less number of population, they live in a particular village, but a city have the more number of population, city has the more number of population than any village. Next one, rural areas, the people, they are very particularly engaged in the primary activities, whereas the people in the urban areas, they are related to the secondary or the tertiary activities. Number, in case of the migration, female, they used to remain in villages in Asian countries, whereas the male, they used to migrate in Asian countries to the cities. So the female, those who remain in their place, in their villages, they used to participate in agricultural works. But in case of the European countries and USA, the North American countries, we used to see that they're just opposite situation. So these are the three basic differences, or four basic differences between the rural urban, between the advanced or the European countries and the Asian countries, relate on the basis of their rural urban composition. Next one, that the what is referred as the literacy, that will be discussed in the next video. So up to this, for this session, only the rural urban composition I have discussed. If you have any problem, if you have any misunderstanding, if you don't have any understanding in on this topic, please write in my inbox. In the comment box, please write. I will give the emphasis on that points of understanding where you need the further discussion. And once again, I'm requesting you to subscribe my channel and obviously press the bell icon to get updates wherever I am giving that the something as a study material, as a part of the discussion. So this session, up to this.